Abetaga okuddamu amaanyi kubanga ffe tukyali mu nsi ezitannazuula nti omwana asobola okubeera ow'akabi ku myaka emimpi. Bannaffe bali abazungu bo bakizuula dda ne bakizuula era abaana mubalaba ku myaka emimpi bo baba batandise okukola ssente, batandise okuinventinga computers n'ebintu ebirala ebiringa ebyo. So kakati naffe twagadde tulete Emmanuella ne ttiimu ye ajje asikirize banne okusobola nabo okwesuula, ate n'abazadde mu ngeri emu nabo baleete n'abazadde bennyini bajje bayigire ku ttiimu eno emanaging omwana ono, nti singa abaana babafunye guidance nga babatambudde nabo bulungi n'omulaga nti kino kye kituufu, kino kye kikyamu, osobola okuzuula talenti ate n'opaying attention nga bano bapaying attention omwana waabwe nabo abaana baabwe ne babeera abaakabi kuba sofa mu Africa ye youngest comedian akyasinze okubeera owaakabi. So gwe mulamwa lwaki tuli wano olunaku olw'omukaaga tugenda kuba wano wenyini ku Serena ku Victoria Hall, we tugenda okuba okuyingira zigenda kuba emitwalo 10 then n'emitwalo 2 n'emmeeza ya miliyoni 2. Then ku Sunday tugende ku Freedom City tujja kubaawo ne tiketi ey'omutwalo ne tiketi ey'emitwalo 2. So embeera bwetyo bwetambula. Twagala kwebaza mwenna media house ez'enjawulo ezituwerekeddeko ku kisaawe, mwenna mwebale nnyo mukirabe engeri gye tumwanirizaamu, bwe tutyo bwe tujja n'okwaniriza abalala bonna singa banaaba bavuddeyo nabo ne bafuuka bakabi. We are happy that the Makenjo crew is here, just as we promised that on the 7th and 8th of September we will be hosting the Makenjo crew, Emmanuella and Success and the team. They are here finally. They arrived at around 9 in the morning. We want to thank every media house that helped us welcome them. And we expect a huge turnover, a turn up on Saturday. Because on Saturday we are here at the Victoria Hall. We have tickets over 100,000. then ordinary, then 200, VIP, then a table of 2 million. This crew is fired up, is they are eager to see the Ugandan audience. We've been seeing their clips on YouTube, on Facebook, and other social media channels, but we have an opportunity of seeing them live on the 7th and the 8th. We brought them to inspire other young kids in Uganda, to show them that they can also make it at a very tender age, they can also make it, and to show parents that if they pay attention to their children, they can notice their talents, they can help them develop those talents, then at the end of the day, before they even finish their studies, they can be earning good money, they can be, you know, fulfilling their dreams. So parents, we welcome you. The kind of comedy they do, though they are kids, the kind of comedy they do is not for children only. It's a family comedy. They act like mothers, like fathers, the whole family. So you don't leave anyone behind on Saturday and Sunday, as we enjoy the comedy of the Mark Angel crew. With me, I have their manager, and I'll request him to brief us on the preparations of Saturday and Sunday. Let me have the manager.
No, the manager is...
Okay. Let me have Mark Angel himself.
So we have issue with the kids, and it is not just the...
I'm here to make people laugh.
Okay. And Mama, let's go to the gun. Emmanuella.
My name is Emmanuella Samuel. I'm here to bring smile to people's face and make them forget about their sorrows.
Okay. That's how
we also have Gabriel here.
Oh,
Mr. Gabriel.
My name is Kilbrand, though original name is Ochuku Kingsley, but I go by the name Kilbrand on the skit. I'm an actor too, comedian, and it's our job, it's our life to make people laugh. That's the objective, to put smile on people's faces. So I think I would love a lot of the Ugandans not to miss this, because it's going to be like one in a lifetime chance. Yeah.
Okay, on top of the crew, we shall have other entertainers from Uganda, because we have some good comedians here. And we have young kids who want to be like Emmanuella and success. One of them is your good friend, Loving Son. So she's here to represent the Ugandan audience, the Ugandan performers. So she's going to tell us how prepared they are. Then I'll put down the list of other performers after that.
Tugenda pela ya baimbi banji, tugenda pela yo ne fresh kid. Tugenda pela yo ne fresh kid, Spicy Diana, Mose Banks, Eddy yawe, tugenda pela yo ne Dax Kachel, tugenda pela yo na abazinyi ba triplets ghetto kid, tugenda pela yo ne ba Maulan and Rain. Moje tugenda kunyumira nyo, moje mundabe nzoma na gendo soko kuimba live music, moje bana ete musuwa, Emmanuella yatuse, kwanu kwa ke Emmanuella ambasaba moje. Bintu vyona vyona vigenda bela ulonji wanokuserena, tugenda bela one red carpet, moje red carpet yeno bulijo red carpet zibe azaba ntubakulu, na yu kuluno naba na wakili ziwa.
Okay. To get that pay lion in your
Okay, that's the crew which is going to accompany the Mark Angel crew. We have other fresh talents.
Like Robin Sanjo, we have a fresh kid. She is around, is now 8 years. 8 years, but he's good when it comes to rapping. He's the male version of Robin Sanjo. So we have other performers like Eddy Away, MC Mandiaki. I think you've seen some of their clips on YouTube. Then we have other performers like the triplets, Ghetto Kids. Those ones are very much international. The triplets, Ghetto Kids, then Spice Dan, and other performers. We shall have a live band. Some of these performers will be in Scotland.
After I was thinking, am I going to stand a little to 10 people? So just bring those 10 people along with you.
Okay, can you briefly tell us the brief history of the Makenjo crew? That's how did you meet these young girls? The brief history about the Makenjo.
Okay, the Makenjo crew started some years ago, and we found Emmanuella, discovered that she would become. At that time, we did not have much of kid influencers. Mm. You know, we had people acting like kids to serve their country, you know, and it wasn't going well content-wise, you know, rating-wise, it wasn't going well. Mm. You know, so we decided, okay, let's have kid for kids, you know, except adults trying to be kids. That was how that came about. Emmanuella. Okay. So as you know, when Emmanuella got to a particular stage, we now said, okay, let's get her back here and then we got success. Before success, there was just Chukwemeka. I'm sure most people know Chukwemeka. And then he had to go to school and now he's back. So we have Emmanuella, success, Chukwemeka. We're bringing in other kids. It's kids for kids. So what? It's like a signboard. You know, that's what Makenjo community is. It's a signboard where you write out messages and put smiles on people's face while you are sending the messages. Mm-hmm. That's the plan of Makenjo.
Do they go to school?
Yes. Yes. They go to school. As much as they are popular. And what you would say, celebrities, we try as much as possible to make sure that they grow up as normal kids. You know, and that's the reason why they attend regular schools. They are not home tutored, so they can pass through the experience that an average kid should, you know, pass through without having to shift.
Some African parents have this thing that when a kid is famous or she gets involved in other activities which are not on the school curriculum, like she does.
I think the reverse is the case, because the exposure they get, we guide these exposures and we direct these exposures to education. Like, it is not every kid that has the opportunity to travel to countries. Even some adults don't know. So I think the one thing that is even helping them in academics is the exposure they get by traveling, and they are doing excellently well in their school.
Okay. How do you balance these travels and the Makenjo crew program? How do you balance it with the school program?
Okay, they have holiday times.
They have holiday?
Yeah, like right now they have holiday, and so we use this holiday to travel to so many countries. Okay. Prior to the holiday, there's always holiday lessons, you know, prior to this time. The school, with the help of the school, and if they're watching, I want to say thank you to, thank you to the school, yeah? So, with the help of the school, were able to give them extra curriculum lessons while they were in school so that they don't have to attend the holiday lessons. You know, like now they are way requirements and the schedule, you know. So the school is really working to make sure that they help them keep balance.
Okay, Emmanuel, how do you feel being a celebrity at that age?
I feel so happy.
So happy. Did you have friends at school?
Yes.
How do they see you? They associate with you like any other student, or they take you like that celebrity you want?
No, they treat me the same.
The same. Okay, and success? The same story.
I've changed my school, so I'm attending my school.
Okay. That's a brief history and how they cope up with their lives away from our smartphone screens. That's their life. So, end of the story, I think, unless I'm going to invite some few questions, but those questions, the technical questions, will be directed to the other big guys. Then those questions which feed the children, because however much they're celebrities, but they are still children. You can't give them those hard or tough questions. So let me invite questions about the show and the market.
But in Nigeria, discovered a fresh kid.
You heard about him?
Yes.
Okay.
We heard about him. Fresh kid, let me say one thing. I don't know how it's going to sound, but most part of our decision coming here, leaving the other show that we're supposed to be at, tomorrow, we're supposed to travel tomorrow to another country. Most of the decision came from the fact that we needed to meet Fresh Kid. And we also heard that he was supposed to shoot a video today. And we say, okay, let's come. And then today we are playing this video. You know, Fresh Kid is part of the people who want to get to Nigeria.
You want to get him to Nigeria?
Yeah, he needs to come from Nigeria. Mm-hmm.
Did you hear about that track when he sang about Emmanuella?
Yes.
If you heard about the track?
Yeah.
So that's why you want them to do something together. Can you sing? Emmanuella, can you sing?
Mother cannot sing.
Okay, Skinny, what was it? Okay.
It's from our community. She is from the same community. And he is just five from the community.
Five kilometers?
Yeah.
Okay. So, there are only two.
But we're here, we can have something. Now that we're here, we can have something, right? But we didn't have that in mind, right? I'm going to be honest and tell you that we actually were coming and saying, I want to meet the Fresh Kid and I want to be in his video. You know? And now, just a few minutes, I think less than 2 hours, these two have become like, you know, bonded.
Mm-hmm.
And I share their parents. Okay. The question about contracts, yeah, every kid is in a contract.
How long?
Yeah.
How long?
It's 1 year. Yeah, it's 1 year. I don't know about your country, but in my country, you don't have more than 1 year for a kid.
More than?
Yeah, you don't have more than 1 year.
Okay.
So that you have the parents can have option of, you know, doing whatever they want.
Okay.
Kid contract is really very flexible. Mm-hmm. Most of it is just for kid. The parents decide what they want to do. Okay. Now for comedy.
We used to hear about the Genevieve Nagis,
yeah,
and the rest of the crew. How did you penetrate through them?
It's going to sound funny to you. Nigeria is actually a home of comedy. The day-to-day activity that happened in Nigeria, if you show it on screen, you will laugh and break your lips.
Okay?
Now, things started getting very hard for some people, you know, because of the African thing that is happening now. And then people started living their life, and their life is what you see as coming to right now. You see that a lot of boys are coming on Instagram. It has become a means of survival right now. Well, a lot of boys are becoming, black boys, girls, young people, were becoming influencers. No, and we, as brothers, we know that once something is working for us, we improve it. That's something that Africa, you know. Mm. So that is what is happening in Nigeria.
Okay, and what happened to the movie industry was this. Okay.
And how Hollywood moved to screen was, Hollywood went to TV, you know, and they played DVD. After the TV era, we now have big screens. That's what's happening to Nigeria right now. So we're having the old actors going to screen and from going to TV. From TV, what's going to happen? It has started happening already though. On the low key, we're having big screen movies on Netflix right now in Nigeria. So it's Hollywood is going to come back and come back big. Just like it happened in Hollywood, also happened in Hollywood. Yeah, is it true?
Okay, let's have. Hi, my name is Ryan.
Please, you want to ask that question again?
You know, when we are growing up, everyone has that big person. When I grow up, I'll be like so and so. I'll be like here in the movie industry of Uganda. We used to move up to Genevieve Naji and then Motola, that's other guys. So, did you look up to someone?
Genevieve. Yes,
You want to be like her?
Yes.
Okay, and then the question you asked, if she contributes. Yeah, they contribute. You write a script and you need somebody to interpret it. But the person needs to interpret it the way she or he would interpret it if it was happening to him or her. So you allow that.
Okay.
Right. Now, that was...
Serious.
Okay, go. You
want to ask? Stop the video.
Okay, Emmanuella bought a door sometimes and she jerks it out. Right, that's what she's calling dumb baby, right? That's the door she bought. What's her name?
Mother.
Anna.
How much was it?
Just that it was quite precious to her, you know. And then talking about spending money, the kids they don't spend money, you know. You shouldn't allow that to happen. Their money is for the future. You only use their money to make sure that they drive towards their future. When they grow up, that's when they can not decide what they want to do with their money. But basically, the things that they need, their parents decide, they want a car, this car. But she doesn't say, I want this particular car right now. All you need is a car to go to school. You know, all you need is a house to live in. You don't want to say, I want 10 story buildings right now. So when she goes, what she decides what she will do with her money. How parents can encourage your kids, right? So allow the kid to decide what he or she wants to be, you know, and your job is to guide, you know. And then I want to state that these kids, the kids in Uganda that made us come here, growing fresh kids, when Robin say fresh kid is from Uganda. One thing I understood was that there are lots of Ugandan parents that understand that they allow, they have to allow their kids. And then I want to say that I am very happy that there are lots of key celebrities in Uganda. It is not in every country that you see parents allowing their kids. So I want to commend whatever it is that you are putting in place, whether laws or rules, I want to commend it. It's the next step in Africa.
Okay, chibuze chela chabade cha meza. Chibuze chabade cha meza. Okay, chibuze chabade cha meza. Akati, tuina, he asked about the entrance fee. Tuina.
The main reason for our children.
Makini.
Yeah, I'll go to some shopping. I can wait for
shopping. Are you going to have some? Are you married first of all?
It depends on what is going to come after that question.
Nothing. We're going to stop at that. Are you married?
I can be married.
Think you can, that is future tense.
No, yes, I can.
That's a possible tense, but I can
be married after this experience. After Uganda. I can be married.
Yeah. Okay, so what should we expect from you? Mama success.
Apart from Mama's success, I'll be playing other roles too.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be playing as Mackenzie's girlfriend.
So,
I agree.
I agree. You
please, can you be my girlfriend without being.
So, what can we expect
from them?
It's our land and rain.
Yes. We see them on YouTube.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we will subscribe to that channel.
Okay.
Yeah.
So most of their comedy is in Luganda. Do you?
One very big comedian that I'm friends with is Anikasine. Yeah. And Adoha. Anichara Adoha.
Okay.
I mean, she inspired me. When Ali Kasime was still having 100k subscribers, I used to be on her channel every day. Okay. Send her messages. I love you, man. I love your comedy, man. And then that's how we won.
Did she reply you?
Yes. Yes. That was the first time I felt like I was doing something.
Unfortunately, she's off the hook. I would see her number for you.
Thank you.